Today we are going to discuss the salient features of Human Genome Project. That means the information which we obtain after the completion of Human Genome Project are known as the salient features of Human Genome Project. Now we know that the Human Genome Project was completed in 2003, but actually it was completed in May 2006 after the sequencing of the chromosome number 1. Now the expected number of nucleotide base at the starting of Human Genome Project was 3 billion, and after the completion of Human Genome Project, it was find out that the human genome, mainly contains 3,164.7 million nucleotide bases. So that is the first information, which we obtain after the completion of Human Genome Project. That is the human genome. Contains 3,164.7 million, that is we can say that 3.165 billion nucleotide base pair. So that is the first information which we obtained after the completion of Human Genome Project. Now the estimated number of genes, at the initial part of the Human Genome Project was 80,000 to 1,40,000 number. That means the expected or the estimated genes were present in human genome is approximately 80,000 to 1,40,000. But actually, only 30,000 genes were find out in human genome. So when we consider the estimate or the total number, of genes is estimated at 30,000, while the previously estimated number of genes is approximately 80,000 to 1,40,000. And when we consider the genes, then genes are mainly consist sequences, or the DNA, consist sequences. Now when we consider all the human beings, these all human beings, mainly comprises 99.9% nucleotide bases are similar. That means 99.9% nucleotide bases are exactly the same in all the individual of the human species. So we can say that here, almost 99.9% nucleotide bases are exactly same in all individuals of human species. यानी कि आप कोई भी ह्यूमन इंडिविजुअल ले लोगे तो उसमें 99.9% न्यूक्लियोटाइड बेसिस एग्जैक्टली कैसे हो गए, सेम. ओनली द डिफरेंस सीन इन 0.1% न्यूक्लियोटाइड बेसिस. नाउ व्हेन वी कंसीडर द एवरेज जीन साइज ऑफ द ह्यूमन, देन इट इज कंसिस्ट अराउंड 3,000 बेसिस. That means here we can say that the average average jean size is around 3000 bases. Around 3000 bases. But the size of all the jeans, okay, vary greatly. That means if you consider the many jeans, then all jeans do not have the same size, that is around 3000 base. Some jeans have the larger size, while the some jeans have smaller size. And the largest gene which found in the human genome, which called for dystrophin, has 2.4 million bases. Okay, that means here by size, okay, the largest gene we can say by size, okay, which codes for which protein? Dystrophin has size nearly 2.4 million bases. So see here, the single gene which codes for dystrophin has the size around 2.4 million bases. That means we can say that here the size of the genes are different, okay? That means some genes have small size and some genes have larger size. Now when we consider these 30,000 genes which were estimated, okay, by Human Genome Project, so here the functions are unknown for over 50% of this discovered gene. So for example, if the discovered genes, okay, consider 30,000 genes were discovered, so only the 50% genes, okay, were identified. That means their functions are known, while the functions of the 50% of these discovered genes are unknown. So we can say that the functions are unknown for over 50% of all the discovered genes. Now we know that the human or any DNA has two type of sequences, okay, coding sequence and non-coding sequence. Now when we consider the human genome, so only or less than 2% of this total genome, okay, codes for protein. That means the 90% of the genome do not code for any proteins. Means here we can say that less than 2% of total genome codes for protein. Right? That means 98% of the total genome, okay, do not code for any proteins. Now when we consider the human genome, the whole sequence of the human genome, then most of part of this sequence, okay, is made up of repeated units. That means the repeated sequences make up very large portion of human genome. So the next point is, these repeated sequences make up very large portion of human genome. Now when we consider this repeated sequence, then repeated sequence containing DNA is also known as satellite DNA. This repeated sequence containing DNA is also known as satellite DNA. And satellite DNA has two types, okay. The first type, that is known as microsatellite DNA, and the second type, that is known as microsatellite and mini satellite. So what is the difference between this micro and the mini satellite? Now repeated sequence, when we consider, for example, if you consider the C A G, and if you consider this is a one unit of three nucleotides. Now suppose this unit, okay, is repeated, okay, many times. For example, this C A G C A G C A G C A G C A G. Okay, then that is called a repeated sequence in which your repeated unit is repeated many times, and this single repeated unit has how many? Three nucleotides. Now if this repeated unit, okay, has either 2 or 10, that means between 2 and 10 nucleotides, then this sequence, okay, or this type of sequence is known as microsatellite DNA. That means in microsatellite DNA we can say that the repeated unit, okay, has 2 to 8 base pairs. Okay, but now if this repeated unit, okay, has more than 10 up to 100 base pair, okay, then that type of sequence containing DNA is known as mini satellite DNA. So let here one example, okay, consider C A T T A A C G C C T A. So here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 and 12. So consider that is the one unit, okay, has 12 base pair, and this 12 base pair containing a single unit is repeated many times. For example, here C A T T A A C G C C T A. Similarly, consider C A T T A A C G C C T A. Then that type of sequence containing DNA is known as mini satellite DNA. Mini satellite DNA. So if the repeating unit contains only 2 to 8 base pairs, then that type of DNA is known as microsatellite DNA. But if the repeating unit has 10 to 100 base pairs, okay, then that type of DNA is known as mini satellite DNA. Now when we consider this repeating unit, so this repeating unit or this repeated sequences, okay, may be repeated many times. Sometime, okay, it repeats 100 to 1000 times also. That means these repetitive sequences, okay, are stretches of DNA sequence that are repeated many times, okay, and sometimes it repeats 100 to 1000 times. Now when we consider these repeated or repetitive sequences, that is this satellite DNA, then this satellite DNA, okay, are not responsible for coding any protein. That means we can say that they are thought to have no direct coding functions, but they are responsible, okay, or they are responsible to understand the function, okay, of chromosome, the structure of chromosome and the evolution of chromosome. That means these repetitive sequences are not responsible for coding any protein, but these sequences are useful to understand the chromosome structure, the chromosome dynamics and the evolution. Now when we consider these 30,000 genes which were present in human genome, mainly these genes are located on chromosome. So now from the Human Genome Project, okay, the number of genes which are located on each chromosome were found out. Now when we consider the largest chromosome, that is considered is chromosome 1, and the chromosome 1 is the largest chromosome. Why? Because it consists around 2968 genes. That means 2968 genes are located on chromosome 1. When we consider the smallest chromosome, that is known as Y chromosome, which is an example of sex chromosome. And this Y chromosome, that is sex chromosome, only contains 231 genes. Okay, so according to the number of genes which are located on chromosome, the largest chromosome is chromosome 1, okay, where 2968 genes are located. But when we consider Y chromosome, then Y chromosome is the smallest chromosome because it contains only 231 genes. Now the scientists, okay, have identified about 1.4 million locations, okay, where the single base DNA differences occurs in human. That means when we compare the individual of the human species, okay, then mainly in the genome of those individuals, about at 1.4 million locations, a single base DNA difference occurs, and that is known as single nucleotide polymorphism. So here, the scientists have identified for 1.4 million 1.4 million locations where single base DNA difference occur in human. Okay, and this single base DNA difference is known as single nucleotide polymorphism. And the abbreviation, okay, for single nucleotide polymorphism is SNPS. That is, in short, okay, it is pronounced as SNPs, right? That means at 1.4 million location, okay, only a single base in DNA, okay, was found different in the individual of human species, and that is known as single nucleotide polymorphism. Now to understand this, okay, now let the individual one, and suppose we find out the sequence of the chromosome 1, and we write down here the small stretch of the DNA sequence. So write down here CCTAGCTACCTCACTTAG. So we write down the small sequence of the chromosome 1 of individual 1. Now similarly, we write down the sequence of the individual 2 for the same chromosome. That means write down here chromosome 1. So here write down the same sequence, that is CCTAGC. Now left this T and write down ACC. T C A C T T A G. So you see, in both individual, when we compare this sequence, so all the nucleotides or all the bases are same of chromosome 1, but there is only one difference is found, okay, in place of this T. That means in place of T, for example, here the another base is there, G. So what happened here, because of the change of this one nucleotide or one base, okay, in both chromosome or in the same chromosome of both individual, what happened? It codes for the some other protein, because we know that this DNA sequence, okay, undergo transcription for the synthesis of mRNA, and that mRNA undergoes translation, where the genetic codes are read by tRNA and specific amino acid ring and binds by peptide bond and form polypeptide chain. Okay, and that type of difference in DNA due to the single base or single nucleotide is known as single nucleotide polymorphism. Now in the later section of this chapter, okay, we have to study about the DNA fingerprinting. And in that DNA fingerprinting, okay, mainly we have to focus on the satellite DNA as well as this type of SNPs, that is single nucleotide polymorphism. Now when we consider as the board examination point of view, then this topic is very important for 3 marks. So you have to learn, okay, this topic very briefly, because that is very important for your board examination point of view.